A warm welcome to all my students. Today, we will study about Indian physiography. We will learn about the following in this chapter: general features of the landforms of India, physiographic divisions of India, important features of the physical divisions. These are the three topics will be discussed in this chapter. In the previous session, we had discussed about general features of the landforms of India, physiographic division of India, important features of physical division. In that, we had learned about Northern Mountain, Northern Great Plain, Peninsula, Plateau. And now we will be learning about the coastal plains and islands. Coastal plains. The plateau of Peninsula India is fringed by coastal plain on either side. It extends from the Rung of Kutch in the west to the delta of the Ganga in the east. The coastal plain can be divided into two parts: western coastal plain and eastern coastal plain. Coastal plain. The coastal plains are extended from Rung of Kutch to Ganga Delta. The coastal plains are extended from Rung of Kutch to Ganga Delta. The coastal plains are divided into two parts: west coastal plain and east coastal plain. Western coastal plain and eastern coastal plain. The western coastal plain. It lies between the Western Ghats and the Arabian Sea. It is extended from Rung of Kutch to Kanyakumari. It is narrow, steep and rocky. It can be divided into three parts: Konkan coast, which lies to the south of the Gujarat plain, extended from Daman to Goa; Karnataka coast, which is extended from Goa to Mangalore; Malabar coast, which is extended from Mangalore to Kanyakumari. Western coastal plain. It lies between Western Ghats and Arabian Sea. It is lying between Western Ghats and Arabian Sea. It is extended from Rung of Kutch to Kanyakumari. And it is divided into three parts. The Konkan coast lies to the south of Gujarat plain. It is extended from Daman to Goa. Karnataka coast is extended from Goa to Mangalore. Malabar coast, Mangalore to Kanyakumari. So, remember, three parts. The Western Ghats is divided into three parts: Konkan coast, Karnataka coast and Malabar coast. We discuss now about the western coastal plain. The western coastal plain is lying between the Western Ghats and Arabian Sea. Here is the Western Ghats and Arabian Sea. So, western coastal plain is lying between Western Ghats and Arabian Sea. It is extended from Ram of Kutch to Kanyakumari. Ram of Kutch to Kanyakumari. It is divided into three parts. First one, Konkan coast. Second one, Karnataka coast. Third one, Malabar coast. Konkan coast. It lies in the south of Gujarat plain from Daman to Goa. From Goa to Mangalore, it is Karnataka coast. From Mangalore to Kanyakumari, it is Malabar coast. Next, we will learn about Eastern Coastal Plain. Eastern Coastal Plain extended from north of river Subarnarekha to Kanyakumari. It lies between Eastern Ghats and Bay of Bengal. It is broader than the Western Coastal Plain. Many rivers of South India flow across the plain and they have formed deltas. Mahanadi, Godavari, Krishna and Kaveri. The Eastern Coastal Plain was extended from river Subarnarekha to Kanyakumari. It is lying between Eastern Ghats and Bay of Bengal. Remember, many rivers in South India flows across this plain and they have formed deltas like Mahanadi, Godavari, Krishna and Kaveri. The Eastern Coastal Plain. Here is the Eastern Coastal Plain. Here is the Eastern Coastal Plain. It is extended from Subarnarekha to Kanyakumari. It lies between Eastern Ghats and Bay of Bengal. It is lying between Bay of Bengal and Eastern Ghats. And here many rivers in South India flow through this plain. And mainly all these rivers form a delta. The rivers like Kaveri, Krishna, Mahanadi, Godavari, these rivers form a delta in this plain. So these are the rivers which form the delta in the Eastern Coastal Plain. River Mahanadi, a triangular shape you see near the Eastern Coastal Plain, we call it as delta. You see a triangular shape, we call it as delta. River Mahanadi, Godavari, River Krishna, Kaveri. These are the rivers which form delta in the East Coastal Plain. The most important rivers in India. Indus, Brahmaputra, Ganga, Narmada, Tapti. Traditionally, the Eastern Coastal Plain is divided into two parts, Northern Sarkar and Coromandel Coast. Northern Sarkar, which lies to the north of River Krishna. Southern part, which is called Coromandel Coast. Some lagoons are formed in this coastal plain, such as Lake Chilka Lake Pulicat Lake Kolelum. East coastal plain is divided into two parts, Northern Sarkar, Coromandel Coast. The north of River Krishna is Northern Sarkar. The south of River Krishna is Coromandel Coast. Lagoons. Lagoons are a stretch of salt water separated from the sea. Such type, we have three lakes, Lake Chilka, Lake Pulicat and Lake Kolelo. Importance of coastal plain. Coastal plains of India provide some natural harbor which helps in carrying on foreign trade. They are Kandla, Mumbai, Marmagova, Kochi, Visakhapatnam, Kolkata. The coastal plain are useful for fishing, shipbuilding, agriculture, production of salt. And many beaches are found along the coast and they attract tourists. Backwater are useful for navigation. Importance of coastal plain. So these natural harbors help us to carry on trade. Many ports are located in these coastal plains, Kandla, Mumbai, Marmagova, Kochi, etc. Coastal plains are mainly useful for fishing, shipbuilding, agriculture, production of salt. Fishing, shipbuilding, agriculture, production of salt. And many beaches are found along the coast. Beaches attract tourists. Backwaters are useful for navigation. That is for transport purpose. Next, we will learn about islands of India. There are about 247 islands in India. Of these, 204 are in the Bay of Bengal and 43 are in the Arabian Sea. The Andaman and Nicobar Island are in the Bay of Bengal. The Lakshadweep Islands are in the Arabian Sea and are formed by corals. In India, there are 247 islands. In that, 204 are in the Bay of Bengal and 43 are in the Arabian Sea. Andaman and Nicobar Island are in the Bay of Bengal. Lakshadweep Island are in the Arabian Sea and are formed by corals. Here, observe this picture of India map, and here is the Andaman and Nicobar Island. There are 247 islands in India. 204 islands are located on Andaman and Nicobar Island. Nicobar Island located on Bay of Bengal. Lakshadweep Island. In Lakshadweep, there are 43 islands. Let's start with the assignment. Differentiate between Western Coastal Plain and Eastern Coastal Plain. Here, you will write the difference between the Western Coastal Plain and Eastern Coastal Plain. First, Western Coastal Plain lies between Western Ghats and Arabian Sea. It is extended from run of Kutch to Kanyakumari. It is narrow, steep and rocky. It can be divided into three parts: Konkan Coast, Karnataka Coast and Malabar Coast. So these points you will write for Western Coastal Plain. Eastern Coastal Plain. It is extended from north of river Suvarnarekha to Kanyakumari. It lies between Eastern Ghats and Bay of Bengal. It is broader than the Western Coastal Plain. Many rivers of South India flow across the plain and they have formed deltas. The river Mahanadi, Godavari, Krishna and Kaveri. Next, second question. Explain about the island of India. In India, there are 247 islands. 204 are in Bay of Bengal and 43 are in Arabian Sea. Andaman and Nicobar Island are in the Bay of Bengal. Lakshadweep Island are in the Arabian Sea and formed by coral. So these are the points you have to write it in the second question. Next, name some important ports of India. So those are Vishakhapatnam, Kolkata, Kochi, Marmagova, Mumbai. These ports. The next one, write a short note on coastal plain. Coastal plain, the plateau of peninsular India, is fringed by coastal plain on either side. It is extended from the run of Kutch in the west to the delta of Ganga. The coastal plain can be divided into two parts, the West Coastal Plain and East Coastal Plain. So these are the questions you have to write it in your homework book. You have to draw the India map and mark these places. In the first map of India, you will mark the physical feature. The first one, Northern Mountain. You have to mark the Northern Mountain. Next, Northern Great Plain. Peninsula Plateau, which you see in triangular shape, is the Peninsula Plateau. Green in color, you see towards the east and the west side, is Western Ghats and Eastern Ghats. And you have to mark the coastal plains and island. Lakshadweep and Andaman Nicobar Island has to be drawn. These are the places have to be marked. Next, in the next outline map of India, mark the important places. You will mark the river Indus, Ganga, Brahmaputra. Three rivers you have to mark. Aravali Ranges, Vindhya Range, Deccan Plateau. So these are the places you have to mark in this. Remember, Indus, Brahmaputra, Ganga, Aravali range, Vindhya range, Satpura. So these are the places you are going to mark in the outline map of India. Here you will mark Nilgiri Hills. From this map you have to mark the Nilgiri Hills in the outline map of India. And with this you will also write the rivers which are flowing in South India. In the previous slide I showed you which are the rivers flowing in South India. Mark those places. With that you should mark the three parts of western coastal plain, that is Konkan coast, Karnataka coast, Malabar coast. In the eastern coastal plain you will mark Northern Sarkar. South of Krishna is Coromandel coast. So these are the place you have to mark in the outline map of India. Thank you, children. We'll meet in the next session with a new lesson. Thank you.